Welcome to Decoded by Christina. Today, I'll be talking about how to create a sticky footer using CSS Flexbox. Let's get started. Most web pages have the same basic layout, a header, some content in the middle, and a footer at the bottom. Right now, there's enough content to fill the page on my browser, but someone else looking at the same page may be using a larger screen with a larger browser viewport, so they'll see extra space below the footer. Or sometimes, you may just not have enough content to fill the entire page. To keep the footer at the bottom of the page, even when the content is short, we can create what is commonly called a sticky footer. In most cases, you won't know the exact height of the user's browser, so it's not recommended to use fixed heights when creating page layouts. Instead, we can use Flexbox to create flexible containers. Tools like CodePen are designed for testing smaller code snippets, so the HTML and body tags that are required when creating HTML pages don't need to be added to CodePen's HTML panel. They're already included in the back end of the tool. This is what the full HTML markup looks like with the HTML and body tags included. When using Flexbox, start by identifying the parent element that contains the items you want to apply the flex styles to. In this case, we want to expand the main content area, so the parent element is body. Even though we can't see the body tag in the HTML panel, it is included in the tool, so we can still use body as a selector to apply CSS styles to it, which I'll add to the CSS panel. Then I'll use the display property with a value of flex. This will activate the Flexbox layout and designate body as the flex container, making the header, main, and footer elements the flex items. By default, flex items are arranged side by side in the same row. However, I want the elements to remain stacked on top of each other, so I'll override this by adding flex direction set to column. Before adding more flex styles, let's talk a bit more about the body element, which represents the visible area in the browser. All page content is contained within the body, and by default, it's only as tall as its content. I'll add a border style to the body element to demonstrate. To position the footer at the bottom of the page, which is basically the bottom of the body element, we first need to make sure that the body element expands to the full height of the browser window. To achieve this, we'll use the height property. It's also common to set the height of the HTML element as well, for good measure. Use height with a flexible unit to fill the entire page. 100% or 100VH, which is a newer unit that represents the viewport height. Both options achieve the same result. Now we're ready to expand the main content area using the flex property, which is shorthand for three properties: flex grow, flex shrink, and flex spaces. To apply this style, add it to the element that needs to be expanded. In this case, it's the main element. I'll start with the flex grow property, which determines the amount an element should expand to fill the remaining space. If I use a value of 0.5, it would only occupy half of the remaining space, so make sure to use a value of 1 when you want to fill up all the remaining space. Technically, this is all you need to create the sticky footer effect. However, the flex grow property is typically used in combination with flex shrink and flex spaces. The flex shrink value should be set to 0 to prevent the height of the main element's content from shrinking. We always want it to expand to fill up any extra space. Flex spaces is used to set the height of the element. To make it flexible, set it to auto. This means that the element will have a minimum height equal to its content, but will also adjust based on the flex grow value. When learning, it can be useful to use the longhand properties to clearly see which style is being applied. But when writing CSS, less is more. So once you're familiar with it, using shorthand properties can help reduce the amount of CSS code that you write. To use the shorthand flex property, make sure to declare the values in the following order: flex grow first, then flex shrink, and finally, flex spaces. Each value should be separated by a space. To learn how to create a sticky footer using CSS Grid, check out my video listed in the description below. Thanks for tuning into this edition of Decoded by Christina. See you next time. Bye.